story of how the world's first electromagnetic motor came into existence. This is the story of some wonderful series of experiments and discoveries from 1820 and 1821. This is the story of three scientists whose research, whose insights revealed the secret of nature, the relationship between electricity and magnetism. Their work opened up a whole new branch in physics called electromagnetism. On April 21, 1820, Hans Christian Oersted, while preparing for his lecture that involved a demonstration at University of Copenhagen, Denmark, while setting up the apparatus for his demonstration, he noticed that when a current-carrying wire is brought near a magnetic needle, the needle deflects. In absence of electric wire, the needle comes back to its alignment in Earth's north-south direction. Intrigued by this observation, Oersted performed more experiments, and he established that electric current produces magnetic field, the basic fact of nature. Electric current produces magnetic field. He did not investigate this much further. He did not do any mathematical analysis. And he thought the magnetic field produced by this wire when current is sent through it is parallel to the wire. Later, Oersted published a pamphlet explaining this phenomena, this particular secret of nature that electric current produces magnetic field, and distributed this pamphlet to the scientific community. Later in the same year, 1820, a French physicist, Francis Arago, demonstrated Oersted's experiment to a gathering of scientists at French Academy of Sciences. André Marie Ampere was in the audience, the same Ampere whose name is given to the unit of current. Ampere was in the audience, and this particular demonstration triggered his interest, and he decided to dive deeper to investigate this phenomenon. This is Ampere's experiment setup. There is a straight wire here, red color wire, which is passing through this cardboard. Wire is perpendicular to the plane of the cardboard. So I'm going to use this compass to detect the magnetic field produced by this wire when we pass current through it. Let me connect the other end of the battery here and there. Ever so slight deflection, but the magnetic needle did deflect. Let me disconnect this and see. There, when I connect it, see the deflection. This magnetic needle, if you take it around this wire, the arrowhead can be used to plot the magnetic field. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to repeat this experiment with a slightly different setup, where we'll see more pronounced deflection of the magnetic needle. So to see a strong deflection in the magnetic needle, I have built this using insulated copper wire that is used for winding of motors and transformers. There are 22 turns in this rectangular coil. So there are 22 straight conductors passing through this hole in the acrylic sheet. And what I've got here is concentration of 22 wires and higher density of current in this area, and hence stronger magnetic field that will give us bigger deflection in the magnetic needle. Let us repeat that experiment that I did with a single wire. If undisturbed, this magnetic needle always aligns in Earth's north-south direction. Like now, the red side of the needle points to north. It will get disturbed only if I bring another magnetic material near to it, like this iron nails. Iron is magnetic material. Or I bring another magnet near to it. See that? So if the magnetic needle moves from its position, it's an evidence that a magnetic field is produced somewhere near it. So now let me connect the power source to the coil and watch the behavior of the magnetic needle. And look, there it turns. If I change its position, the magnetic needle changes its deflection angle. And this is pointing towards north. So there we go. Now it's pointing in a different direction. So as I move it around the central conductor, the magnetic needle points in different directions. So this way, if I take the magnetic compass all around the conductor and draw my arrow from south to north, south to north, we can actually plot the magnetic field around that conductor. That's exactly what Ampere did, and came to a conclusion that the magnetic field produced by this conductor is circular in nature. As opposed to what Oersted was thinking, Oersted thought the magnetic field was parallel to the conductor. So basically, this experiment establishes the nature of the magnetic field produced by a wire that is carrying current and that is circular in nature. After investigating the relationship between electricity and magnetism experimentally, Ampere published his work, his research, on 18th September 1820 and made it available to other scientists. In the year 1821, Michael Faraday, who was working with British Royal Society, set out to understand Oersted's and Ampere's work. He focused on the circular nature of the magnetic field produced by current-carrying straight wire. This fact was established by Ampere earlier in 1820, and he focused on that, and he thought if the magnetic field produced by the current-carrying straight conductor is circular, it ought to produce rotational motion or circular motion. Superb insight, superb thought. With this idea, he set out to work in his laboratory on 3rd September 1821 at 9 a.m. And finally, by 5 p.m., he had ended up with this kind of motor. This was world's first electromagnetic motor. This is the model of what Faraday actually built in his laboratory. This is the model of Faraday's motor, or world's first electromagnetic motor. I have a plastic container here filled with salt water, aluminum foil, a magnet kept at the center of the container, and this piece of wire that is hanging from another wire. The end of that wire is here. In Faraday's motor, mercury was used for conduction of the current, but I am using salt water. Mercury is toxic and we don't use it for experiments like this. So what we are going to do is, I am going to connect the power source to one end of this wire. Current will pass through this hanging piece of wire, go into salt water, into that electrode, which is aluminum foil, and back to the power source. So once we pass the current, this piece of wire is going to produce its own magnetic field, which is going to be circular around that wire. So the magnetic field produced by this wire and the magnetic field of this permanent magnet will interact and the wire will rotate. That's what Faraday expected from the experiment. Let us now pass current through this setup and watch the action. Positive terminal and negative terminal. There goes Faraday's motor, world's first electromagnetic motor. Let's have a closer look. You see those bubbles? What's happening is this is salt water and electrolysis is going on. Salt has split into sodium and chlorine ions. Chlorine is getting released at positive terminal and hydrogen at the negative terminal. You can see those bubbles there. This motor had no practical use, but that was not intention of Michael Faraday. His intention was purely scientific. He just wanted to investigate the relationship between electricity and magnetism and create the rotational motion, and he did it. This is the first electromagnetic motor in the world. The practical motor was invented by William Sturgeon in 1832. This motor was invented in 1821. So this was an absolutely wonderful discovery by Michael Faraday and an invention. He ended up inventing world's first electromagnetic motor. Of course, this is not the motor of any practical use, and that was not his intention. Michael Faraday's intention was only scientific investigation, and whatever idea he had that a circular magnetic field ought to produce a circular motion, and he succeeded in making world's first motor. This motor by Michael Faraday is also known as homopolar motor. Why it is called so? Because in this motor, unlike the motors that we see today, AC motor, DC motors, in drill machines, mixers, and at various applications, the current in this is only in one direction and the magnetic field is also in one direction. The directions of current and the magnetic field in this motor do not change, and yet they produce the rotational motion. So such motors are called homopolar motor. I'll be showing you one more modern version of a homopolar motor, beautiful and simple motor anyone can build. Later, after this, I'll show you that. Here is the modern day homopolar motor. As I had mentioned earlier, Faraday's motor is homopolar motor, which means the direction of current and the direction of magnetic field in that motor does not alter, does not change as it does in the modern motors. This homopolar motor has, this is what I've stuck here are the magnets and a cell, a dry cell, and a very simple armature that connects the positive of the battery on top with the negative of the battery through the magnet. That's your modern day homopolar motor. I'll be making a special video on how to make these homopolar motors and how they work. A separate video will come up. Here is a different shape. How this motor works is when I drop the armature, it connects the positive from top with the negative down, and current flows on both sides of the armature, generating Lorentz force. There's a separate video I've made on Lorentz force there. And that Lorentz force on the two sides of this coil or armature makes it turn. I need to balance this nicely. There it is. As I said, there is a separate video on Lorentz force in action. The link to that video is in the description. Here is one more shape. You can experiment with various shapes there. A different shape, homopolar motor. So, this was an absolutely wonderful discovery by Michael Faraday and a superb invention. He ended up inventing world's first electromagnetic motor. This motor is not practical. We cannot use this motor anywhere, and that was not the intention of Michael Faraday. He had not set out to make a motor that can be used somewhere. His investigations were purely scientific. He just had a thought that if the magnetic field produced by a straight wire that is carrying current is circular, it ought to produce a circular motion, and he succeeded doing exactly that. The first practical DC motor was invented in 1832 in England by William Sturgeon. The genius of Michael Faraday does not stop here. This was 1821. 1821, he ended up inventing world's first motor, first electromagnetic motor. 10 years down the line, he did something amazing. He discovered another phenomena which was exactly opposite to what Oersted demonstrated. Oersted demonstrated that electric current produces magnetic field. Ampere investigated it further. Michael Faraday dived deeper into it, invented this motor. And 10 years down the line, Michael Faraday discovered exactly the opposite phenomena. Changing magnetic field produces current. He discovered electromagnetic induction in 1831. So two superb discoveries by Michael Faraday. One in 1821 led to invention of motors. And another, that is electromagnetic induction in 1831, led to invention of electric generators, transformers, induction heaters, and lot many other phenomena that involves electromagnetic induction. I'll be making one more video just on electromagnetic induction, the second discovery, the second great discovery by Michael Faraday, coming up soon. So if you have curious mind and inquisitive mind, and you like learning about secrets of nature that are revealed by physics, keep watching my videos on my channel, like them, share them, and do not forget to subscribe to my channel.